Part of the project. I have to. Because other people need to understand also. It's okay. It's in English. Everything is gonna be in English.
Microsoft must stand up.
Now, people that prefer Nike should go over there. And instead of people that they prefer Adidas, that they should go over the other corner.
Because I want to stay seated.
Let me set Coca-Cola, Pepsi.
Ciao. Sei italiano?
No, I say those of you who prefer Pepsi, you stay where you are. Those of you who prefer Coca-Cola, stand up.
And if we don't have a brother?
There's no
such thing. Please.
Wait, we climb the walls.
No, no, straight people instead of gay. Gay people the other side, the straights from here.
Thank you.
bisexual?
Yes.
There is no such an option.
No option. No option. There are so many people who love both sides.
We just gave you two options. You must choose one.
Yeah, but in this moment you say to so many people that they are wrong.
I didn't say.
Yeah, but I think
it's ethical.
You cannot say that there is only homosexuals and homosexuals.
That's not fair. Actually, I said straight, not straight, not straight. So,
it's not okay. I don't do that. I'm in the middle, and I don't want to.
But we didn't say straight or gay. We said straight or not straight.
Yeah, you said instead of, but I can't. But I can't.
I don't want to make a decision.
Okay, let's hear these people. Why?
It's because when you make a decision that you are straight, you're saying, okay, I'm not homosexual, but and if you are, you said all other people, all gay people should go on that side, that's somehow, I don't want to exclude myself from straight people, and I don't want to exclude myself from homosexual people. So I just kind of stay in between. If there's black and white, there must be gray. And it's a decision. It's not that I haven't made a decision. I just choose to say number A, number B, and I choose for number C. So it's you said everyone who made, that didn't make a decision should leave the room, but we made a decision, so we can stay inside.
Yeah.
And we went for Nike. We prefer Nike over Adidas, but I can't make a decision with Pepsi and Coca-Cola, and I can make a decision between straight and homosexual. It's just, I'm in a room full of strange people, and then I have to say if I'm straight or if I'm homosexual, and I think that's somehow strange to choose a side. So I think a few people here are lying because there is something in between, but they just follow the other people because they want to stay in the room. And, we know each other well, so we feel comfortable being together alone in the middle of the room. So
I feel this is very interesting and that we should share with the other people. I'm not sure they can hear you.
Because we can't hear.
Ah, okay, sorry. I didn't know.
You can use a microphone.
Yeah.
I don't want to use the microphone.
So you can speak up. I think you said
okay, you can speak to my ear and I will speak up to
you. Okay. Let's say this thing.
We are in a room full of strange people.
And we make a decision and show our decision.
And we are asked to make a decision and show our decision. By choosing one side of the room. And I feel very uncomfortable
doing that. And then you said everybody who didn't make a decision.
And then you said everybody who didn't make a decision
has to leave the room.
Has to leave the room.
And I don't want to leave the room because I was here yesterday.
And I wanted to leave the room because it was the first time that I came here.
Yeah, because yesterday I was too late and I missed something. So I don't want to leave the room. I made the decision for today
anyway.
Yeah. It's not, sorry.
On the other hand, it's not okay to say there's nothing in between. I think everybody of us has something in us that was part of sexuality.
Gracias.
are vegetarian.
They are vegetarian.
So it doesn't matter, you're on this side, that side, or the other side, or no side at all.
So the Greeks should go over there, and the foreigners the other side. With love.
I feel like I'm being drowned.
I'm trying to find...
To find the...
The passport.
Yeah. Oh, no, I don't have the passport with me. I know
what's wrong
with the passport.
Your ID?
What the card says.
Don't put their numbers on TV.
No, no, sorry.
Sure, yeah. Sorry.
It's Agnes.
Yeah, but I have a...
That's Greek.
You go by name?
It's a Greek name.
You can have another nationality. Dukakis, who is going to be president.
You can have a different nationality.
The U.S. president.
You have to, your commission has to decide.
Okay, can you tell us sincerely why you didn't want to pick a side?
We have dual loyalties.
I actually lived more years, both abroad than in Greece, so.
Where did you live?
Right down Athens, in New York before.
Do you feel New Yorker?
I think so. Once a New Yorker, always a New Yorker.
Performers. Okay, I think it's time to start interpreting the score. Have you all read the score that we're trying to play here? Okay, and since we are in Documenta and the title is Hearing from Athens, all the Greeks should have their own, and we want them, we should teach them
the score. So you should explain them the score.
Όχι, απλά ελληνικά και μόνο ο κύριος ο Νεοερκέζος μας καταλαβαίνει από τους άλλους. Α, μπορεί να μας να πείτε να σας αποκράζετε. Γενικά, όλοι οι περίοδοι. Τι είναι αυτό. Ένα πράγμα μπορούμε να τους δείξουμε.
Πώς θα το δείξω. 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 Πώς θα το
Μπορείτε, αρκεί να πείτε για ποιο λόγο αποχωρείτε ή τη γνώμη σας για το πώς θα το κάνουμε καλύτερα αυτό που κάνουμε στο μικρόφωνο.
Δεν έχουμε καταλάβει που κάνετε.
Α, μπορείτε να πείτε αυτό. Would you like to come with me? You can say whatever you want.
Hello. We are in a hurry. And we haven't understood what is happening here. We wish you the best of luck and enjoy.
Okay, let's do that, Kunelaki. We go over there. Come on. So the Greeks are going to teach you something.
But I'm going to teach you a small poem to say to your children.
Αχ, κουνελάκι, κουνελάκι, ξύλο που θα το φας.
Oh rabbit, you're gonna get spanked.
Μέσα σε ξένο περιβολάκι, τρύπες γιατί τρύπας.
In a strange garden, why are you digging holes?
Μη μου σουφρώνεις τη μητούλα, μη μου κουνάς τα αυτιά.
The gestures go with.
Μη μου κλείνεις τα ματάκια, είσαι μια ζωγράφια. Πέστε τους ότι όλοι οι Έλληνες έχουν μεγαλώσει με αυτό το τραγούδι.
Every single Greek grew up with this song. So the two second verses. Do not make your nose like this. Don't wave your ears. Do not shut your eyes. You're just a picture.
Subject will emerge, as if it's a mushroom growing from the parquet, or what's the assumption? What's the the premise is that there is this kind of politicization of communal relations, but then it comes down to this, you know, very individualistic relational aesthetics, because ultimately the collective subject doesn't grow from the soil. Or like being locked in one room over an hour. Yeah? It's a question.
Yeah.
I'm going to read the end of the score, I mean, which is an imperative, our task, right? So-called, help the collective subject to emerge. I mean, what are the given conditions? Because the collective subject doesn't parachute out of the sky, doesn't, you know, suddenly appear as like the Holy Spirit. It emerges out of social relations. And what are the social relations that are in the objective reality rather than this in this, you know, particular room?
Yeah. I mean, we thought that she was singing alone, so it was not a collective subject. It was
I'm not talking about it. No, I'm talking about the given conditions of the performance. Mm-hmm. And it's demand from us.
So it just shows this is what we have to read, and then we have to decide to say what the reads are doing.
We're given a task. We have to accomplish something.
Yeah.
What are the conditions that are given for accomplishing what is expected from us? Mm-hmm. Does it make sense?
Yeah, of course, it makes sense.
So do you have any suggestions?
No.
He does not suggest.
No suggest.
He does.
No.
Suggest him.
He's supposed to break out the
Anyone else? A suggestion? Something? For the score? For the collected subject?
The audience is your instrument. Play it in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. So, we can discuss this.
Because we're not instrumentalized by social relations. The instrumentalization of social relations is a symptom of commodity relations. So like de-instrumentalizing social relations will not solve your problem with commodities. And I don't have a suggestion.
Greeks on one side and works on the other? Is there...
The coach.
We were asked, what would we choose to teach the foreigners? And some people said, how to cook. Another person said, how to dance. And then the sitaki. We had a demonstration. Some people had other suggestions. So maybe that's why.
I have to go to a friend's birthday party, so I gotta go. So feedback. Listen carefully and try to maybe overthrow the performers. Think about that. That's my feedback. Because that's what performance is sort of about. Don't ask permission, just do something. Okay?
Happy birthday to your friend.
Happy birthday to your friend. Happy birthday to your friend.
Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology.
Do all these words come from the Greek? Narcissism.
Technology.
Strangers to one another. So oftentimes when there's a collective, there's usually a goal. And of course, we're all in our own way narcissistic, and of course we're defined by a material, let's say, what we like. But that we're not around, and of course there's social dissonance as we all go about our own very lives. But we, as a collective, we don't have, let's say, a come and go here. It's just a performance that we are the performers, in a way. But it would be nice to have a collective, let's say, go amongst us. But I don't think the conditions are present in society.
Yeah, we want him here to be entertained.
He's more entertained than hanging around you. It's not so. It's not.
not so much fun to talk about this text anyway, but what you said is totally true, and it's good that you are saying it, because I totally agree with what you said. We have no goal here as a collective, other than we wanted to see a performance.
You don't enjoy our company?
No, I don't enjoy it. Yeah, why?
So, since it's entertainment, that means that we are here to collect an instrument and make music all together.
Music?
We do already music. We're doing music. Yeah.
Music or noise?
Noise is music, isn't it?
Noise is something different. Much louder.
So, what do you think about Yannis Xenakis?
Yes, that I had in my mind, yeah. Quite a different concept of music. So, in my point of view, music is something different. We're trying to make, to synchronize, get synchronized, but there are disturbances all around, because different mentalities. So that's why I have problems of communicating. And in fact, to tell the truth, I can hardly understand the second paragraph. It's all Greek to me. Compare people for concepts and the questions and movements to explore. I don't know how can it be done. This can be done.
So who's preparing the audience? Who's in charge of preparing the audience?
Who's in charge?
It says prepare the audience.
It's a building here. We are
prepare the audience.
We have to prepare ourselves, I'm afraid.
I mean, we're given all these choices, as if they're concepts, weak, foreigner, heterosexual, gay, I mean, these are not concepts. They're just terms, they're not concepts.
Yeah.
Artist from what country?
Bilbao.
It's from Bilbao.
Bilbao?
Bilbao.
Bilbao.
Well, it's quite possible that this particular group sort of did come to be entertained, and maybe there is a lack of the sense of collectivity, collectivism, the collective, which is okay.
My question is, that if you
we're not being the most compliant audience, because if we were to follow the score, which is the expectation, that would mean we would have to play, you know, like with each other, perform, whatever, come up with, you know, kind of mess up with fiction, I guess. And then what? I mean, let's say we were all like compliant, because I think that this is not the case, where there's like some resistance to follow the score. So then let's say we're all playing your role, and then we all become performers in this, and we all play, and then what? Like, what is the, you know, what is it, what is the, because then we're performing, so what does that mean for reality? Or like, what is the relationship?
What the expectation of the performance is just the opposite, not to perform. Mm-hmm. So like that you can experience alienation, and then like somehow experiencing alienation, you come to consciousness about your condition of alienation. And then I don't know.
But I mean, presumably we could be all in the room, get the score, and then decide to like, you know, humor the text. No, so I'm saying in that case, then, well, yeah, then it doesn't work.
Well, the last phrase says here, help the collective subject to emerge. So, you know, I thought somebody had a good idea and they were, you know, it's toward the end, and maybe it's not appropriate to do it now, but somebody was doing the sertaki. So that is collective, that could be a subject, you know, to dance, yet we are still strangers and individuals, but that is an example of the collective emerging.
I sometimes dance with people or our collective subjects.
But you need the move, you need the music, you need the move.
The subject of consciousness, right? That you experience the conditions not individually but shared as a
Thank you.